Major Crimes fans, I'm Zoe Hewitt. Now, it might look like I am walking in the air, but that's not the case. This special backdrop behind me is actually called a trans light.
What's special about it
is that you can light it from the front or the back
to create a day or a night scene. Now, Major Crimes fans, you might recognize this scene behind me, and that's because it comes from right outside of a very special office on the Major Crimes set. In honor of the show's 100th episode, I got to sit down with the entire cast and talk about what the show has meant to them.
Well, congratulations, you guys, 100 episodes. Yay. So exciting.
Thank you. We can't believe it. Like, I can't believe
it. I can't believe it. I feel like I jumped on at the perfect time because...
You're getting all the 100 for like, how many, 15?
All the parties, none of the work. So a little bit of the work. Not very much of the work.
Oh, thanks. Congrats to both of us.
Unbelievable.
Now, the fans are really passionate about this show. Now, one of the things that they were really waiting for a long time was the big wedding.
I looked amazing. Wedding day.
Okay, there. See, that's why I held the mic. It was really fun. It felt like we were at a real wedding. I mean, there were real tears. I was like, I don't know why I'm so emotional, but I'm actually like, I'm so excited for you. And we got to be bridesmaids and dress up and be at a church.
Not all of us got to be bridesmaids. I thought we all got to know each other so much better that day. We were the only thing missing were tequila shots. Or were they?
I'm not saying anything.
Next question.
Was that the after party? Now, coming into this show and to all these actors who have been together for a while, did you feel like also joining this wedding episode really felt like you could jump in? You were part of the family.
I won't say it wasn't intimidating when you join a cast that's been together this long. Kearran's one of the first in the cast to welcome me and let me know that she had a feeling I'd be sticking around.
That's right. You were up. You were not originally.
I was told, I think, 2 or 3 episodes, and I don't know, I just kept getting the calls.
Which is really a great compliment to you when it isn't planned that you will be coming on permanently. It means you've done such a great job. And it's a special treat to get to talk to both of you together. So what is something that each of you can say about each other that you think fans don't know?
I think what the fans really want to know is who wears tighter pants.
Me.
What?
Well,
I got a couple in the wardrobe.
On Thursdays, we like to let it out a little bit.
The audience probably knows you a lot better than they know me, but maybe they don't know that Kearran's the best mom. Hollywood actress, but also full-time mom and incredible. And also really funny. I think I'd like to see them spit out a little more humor and sykes because she's hilarious.
Uh-huh.
She's really
kind of funny, right?
Amazing. Do your cross-eyed thing. Do that. It's hilarious. What is that?
I've got hidden talents.
Hidden talents.
Also, Daniel and I are both germaphobes. Like, not like a lot where we make people crazy, but just like enough that it's a little nutty.
Yeah, you hold the mic.
Right, we're going to actually Purell this and we're done. We Lysol this whole room before we started.
The first time, I think it was, that I interviewed Kearran, she told me about this great fan encounter where you were at the grocery store.
I don't have that problem.
I go
to the Trader Joe's on, you can, anytime you want to say hello, especially if I'm with my friends. To make me look like you care? Okay.
You've been playing your character, Amy, for a long time now. What is something that you've learned from Amy over the years?
I think I've just learned from her to settle in, know where your talent and skill lies, and to be confident.
Congratulations, 100 episodes. Such a big deal.
I'm very glad that we're this far, and I would like to go another 100. I don't know how anybody else feels about it, but...
I can't go another 100, is the issue. I would love to go, but I can't. Not unless they film me at the home with drool coming. That'd be a great job for
you.
You'll wheel me in and wipe me up. Hi.
No, you're being modest. I mean, people love you on the show. And you've got this great bromance going with Tony's character.
I care about him so much I got married to get away from him. He got married as well. I minded that he called her Sharon. If he had always called her Captain, that wouldn't have bothered me. But he called her Sharon at work, and that aggravated the hell out of me. Of course, most things Tony does aggravates me.
Well, now I feel like there's some crossover. Most things Tony does, not most things Andy does.
No. Both. But this sweet thing here, see, she comes in, because I've dealt now for 13 years with this old man. And now I have this gorgeous young creature who is in real life also from Texas, where I'm from. Mm-hmm. So automatically she's aces with me. But she brings a spark. You know, we desperately needed a spark.
It seems like those are some very thoughtful and loving words. And clearly this is a cast that really cares about each other. So what was it like when you came on knowing I'm the newbie, I get to join in on the 100 episodes, but I'm walking into an established cast?
And it was somewhat intimidating to just jump into this train that's moving full speed ahead. And it was like a family that welcomed me with open arms and being a new little sister coming in.
I love this pairing in particular because I think it's really great that we've got so many established actors on the show and newer actors who are coming in. And so what do you feel like you've learned from each other?
Well, I've learned not to giggle. go ahead. There it goes. Don't take much. Of course, I go to great lengths to teach them. But at the same time, what they probably don't know is that I'm learning a great deal from them as I'm instructing. And I think at least they give the great appearance of appreciating 2 cents. And you also get more than 2 cents back. That's important. It's an investment.
Particularly Mary and GW take the extra step to try to teach us. They specifically have taught me how they don't just see what we're doing from the actor's eye, which is how I've always kind of seen things. They very much have a director's eye too while they're doing things, which I've been learning so much from every day. And they'll say, well, if we're walking in this direction, then the audience is going to think that we're trying to teach them something, or we're trying to take their focus in that direction. And I just kind of am usually coming in from, oh, I feel this way, and my character's feeling this way, and they see it so much differently and see it from a storytelling point of view.
What's something that you've taken away from your own characters?
We can't say anything that's coming up, but she has a bit of a flirtatious relationship coming up. I'll just say that.
Well, there's definitely been certain characteristics of mine personally that I've seen being more incorporated into the character. I think the fact that she's not afraid to speak and maybe speaks more than is welcomed.
So first of all, congratulations, you guys. 100 episodes is a really big deal to get this far.
Amazing.
That's what it is, 100 episodes? Thank you very much.
Yes, this is, it's absolutely amazing. Can't believe it.
And we talked, Tony, a couple of years ago now, looking forward
really
to this moment.
Been that long?
It has been.
Wow. That's what, since you came over the house, we did the cooking show?
Yep,
wow,
since you cooked cool. for me. Tony cooked me eggs.
You haven't cooked me eggs, Tony.
I will. We come over to the house, I'll make you.
Okay.
Now, for the show, first things first, I know we've seen it this season, Tony, the wedding episode. I mean, fans have been looking forward to that for years.
Yes. You know what? I can't help it. I'm going to do an exclusive here and tell you about the last episode. I know that they're sitting over there. They're going to be really upset. The last episode, Rusty gets abducted by aliens, and you find out that GW is really not from this planet, that prevents us from another planet, and that he engineered that. I'm sorry, guys.
Gotcha.
Lots of stuff happening, but for the wedding.
Wedding's a big deal, yes. The wedding was a big deal. We were all there, including myself.
In class.
And it was really funny because when Mary came down the aisle, when she was the way they had her lit, I mean, she literally looked like an angel. Don't you think so?
Yeah. No, I mean, it was a great episode to be a part of as a new addition as well, because I think my experience as an actor on the show is kind of coinciding with my character's journey. Like, I really see how this squad is a family, and Chief Mason is seeing the same thing. And being a part of the wedding and then seeing how the unit comes together after that, it's just more insight into how close this team is. And he's trying to navigate that.
And has there been anything that has surprised you that has maybe changed since coming onto the show, changed for you?
With each episode, I just see how close everyone is. Mm-hmm. It just makes coming to work a gas every day.
Yeah, it's a really nice feeling. And it's like family to some degree. No, I mean, well, we all go home and go different ways. We don't all go to the same house and then come back the next morning, like live in a dorm. No, I mean, it's that really nice feeling. My thing always is, this is my home away from home. I come here to play. I don't even use the word work. I come here to play. And when people come to my schoolyard, so to speak, that I'm playing in, first thing I want to do is make sure that they're comfortable, make sure that they have a comfortable place to sit, or they need something to drink, whatever. And that's how I am when you come to my real home. And so why not extend that same, you know, mm-hmm. I mean, otherwise, symbolically, my mother and father, Sicilian immigrants, would be smacking me in the back of the head. If you get up from the chair and say hello to the people. What are you talking about? You know, so that's just the way I am. And Leonard is, Leonard, you know, hit the ground running. I mean, as soon as he came to the show, bam, he just like fit right in. I mean, like right in, as if he had been there the whole time.
And I think that that can be tricky. You know, the producers have to be careful when they're casting that you're not upsetting this balance of chemistry with the actors who have been together for so long.
There is something I could share to this, because in this latest episode, I am, you know, Mason and Commander Raider are now having a little bit of tension. He's he's promoted her. He's brought her in to this new level, and he wants to implement a new agenda for the unit. And sometimes they are at odds, and it's a challenge. As a new actor, I'm like, how am I going to go up against Mary McDonald? Like, but we had a conversation the other day, and Mary said, it's fun, right? It's fun. And it is, because when you're a professional, you have this environment that's so welcoming. You can do the hard stuff. You can do the difficult scenes, the arguments, the back and forth with more freedom because you're in a safe space.
We are in your office. Like, this is your space right now.
Yes, we are.
Which is very special. Was there anything that you requested for the set, particularly thinking, hey, I really like X, Y, or Z, so I'd like this on my in my office?
There is an addition. There's a plaque up there that says, I'll be nicer if you'll be smarter. It was a gift, and it's kind of like my little nod to some very close family, friends, and fans of the show. Mary loves this sofa, by the way.
What about the sofa in particular?
Everything. Three episodes now, she's come up to me and she says, Leonard, have you sat in the sofa in your office? It's the most I want it. It's the most comfortable thing ever.
Not only are we in your office, but we are on the set. And so what do you think is something that fans don't know about these sound stages where you guys come to work all the time?
It's cold.
It's cold. It's cold. Yeah, it's
right. It's very, very cold.
I've been earning a living in this business for 30 years now, and I still will look out the window. And if it's sort of dark when I came in because it's night or something, and it's like a daytime scene, I'll still like say, wait a minute, I thought it was night out. Oh, that's right, it's the lighting. I still get fooled by it.
Tony, when we've talked before about the character, you've had a chance to really watch your character evolve over so many years of playing Andy Flynn. What do you think, though, that you've learned from him over the years?
Wow, that's a good question. What have I learned from Andy? That it's really important when I leave here and I observe something that might look troubling out on the street to leave it up to the people who carry real guns and, you know, real badges. And
I think, right, I don't know if Mason's journey has been as long to warrant real connections, but I can tell you what I admire about him and his dedication to his job. Mm-hmm. And his ability to kind of see all sides.
What is something that you think viewers don't know about you guys that you can say about each other?
Wow. I don't know. So something I could say about him that people don't know about him?
Yeah, Leonard the person.
Well, I can say this. He's a really cool guy, and he's very nice, and he's very affable, and doesn't seem to be any pretense about him at all. I mean, he's like, shakes your hand, and it's a good handshake, and he seems like a solid Joe. He really does. I mean, that's coming from New York. That's a compliment.
He knows not to look at me. I mean, like, not directly.
Well, yeah, there's that.
I mean, I'll shake his hand, but, you know, directly.
All right, Leonard. My nickname for him is Leonard Two Names. Lenny Two Names.